Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from RoboJax. In this video we are going to see how we can control a servo motor using a remote control and Arduino. I'm pressing the button to move the servo to the right, or maybe move it to the left, or just press the center. You can get the code for this project by clicking at the link in the description below, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. At the end I'm going to show you to use your home remote to control the servo. In this video, we're going to use these two commonly sold remote control with Arduino and this receiver, and also we're going to use this module. This is the same one is with the PCB, the other one is without PCB, to control the servo. I have a separate video explaining these remotes and the receiver and how to decode using Arduino. So you have to watch that video and make sure that you can get the value and display on the screen with your remote. After that, come to this video, because if I explain everything here, the video would be very long. I'm going to control the servo either with this white remote, with a black remote, or with a module with a PCB, or without the PCB, the bare module. And also at the end I'm going to show you to use your home remote to control the servo. That you can use this servo or larger servo or this micro servo, doesn't matter, you can control all of them, except with this one, with the larger one, if the Arduino is unable to provide enough power for it, so you have to connect it with the external power. Let me explain the wiring. The servo has three wires. These are the three wires. The dark one is the ground, the middle one is always the 5 volts or a power, so you cannot make mistake. Even if you flip it, it will be always at the middle. And then the lighter color usually is the signal, and this is connected to the ground, as you can see here. And the light, the red one, which is here, the white, connected to 5 volts. And then the orange I've extended with this wire, this is the gray. This is connected to pin 8 and Arduino. For this module, we have three wires here. We have ground, which is connected to the ground. We have the VCC connected to 5 volts. And then we have the signal connected to pin 11, as explained in my original video. Now, this module has been explained there, that has negative on this side. This goes to the ground. The middle one goes to the 5 volts, and S is signal, which goes to pin 11. If you use this module, this is VCC, this is ground, and that's the signal, and I will connect it to this wire. I've bent the pins up for this, so it can receive the signal easily. Now let me explain the code. I'm not going to go through line by line explaining this code, because it has been explained in the required video that I've provided you the link. This is part of the library which will be included. This is the same as the main original video. I'm not going to talk about those. And from here to here, this is for the servo. This is the library for servo, which is part of Arduino. You don't have to download anything. And here we create an instance of this servo, RJ servo. The RoboJax servo is initiated, and we are connecting our servo to pin 9. So we create a constant here, and the angle, the initial angle, whatever you want to set. For some cars, for some equipment, you need to put a certain angle. If you don't have a fixed value, just put 90, because the servo moves between 0 and 180. So 90 will be at the middle, which is appropriate value. And then angle step, this is the resolution, or how fast the servo should move. Every time you press it, this goes 10 at the moment. But if you want to make it 5, so change that, so you have to press it multiple times in order to make it move. You cannot press this continuously, because the detector will detect FFF and it will not work. Here, the angle center, so you can set another angle when you press, let's say, with this we go right, left and right, and with OK we bring it to center. That center is this value. So when you press the button to reset, I should have called this reset. So this is the reset angle. And then this is for the remote. I've used in this example, this is a right key. This is the arrow, which is part of the code that I've explained. And this is for the left. So when you want to move the servo to the right, this button is pressed and we have to put it inside double quotation. Very important. And for the left, we put it there. And for the center or reset, OK. This is O and K capital inside the double quote. So this must be exactly the same. And if you're using this remote, let's say you want to use this channel plus for the right and channel minus for the left and CH for the middle, you have to put exactly as it is. And I forgot to mention here, if you use this remote, we type here capital W inside single quote. And if you use this remote, we type B as a black. And if you're using this module, we set PCB equal 1. If you're using this module, we set PCB equal 0. After this line, you will not change this. This is the white remote PCB codes. This is the white remote without PCB. And these are the key for this white remote. All the values are here, so that's why these must match. With the above setting that I mentioned, so you can control the servo. And this is for the black remote with PCB and so forth. The important part that has changed is this one. So we attach a servo pin, which is pin number 8, to the servo. So we must type rjservo.attach. So this is extra with comparing to the code that you watched. And then inside the loop, nothing has changed. This is exactly the same as before, and we have 50 millisecond delay here. This is like this is the same as original code that I have created. And after that, RoboJack's validate code has not changed, except I put here servo action. In my previous video, it was relay action and some other stuff. So the job of this one is validate code, to validate the code for us and take some action. Here we put servo action and we pass the value that is received to this function. And this is for the white, which is when it's not PCB. And here this is for white PCB, same thing, exact same line. And then for black PCB, we have the same line. And otherwise, which is PCB black with non-PCB. And here is the servo action that I mentioned. The servo action receives the value as a string, and here we check the value. If the value is equal right, the right is the value that we define here, right, left, and center, the three keys. So we say if it's equal right, we check if the angle at the beginning, let's say it's 90 or 0. If it's bigger than 0 and smaller than 180, because when you increment the angle, it usually goes above 180. So we have to make sure that we don't allow that. Or maybe if you go for the left side, if you go to the 0, again, you will reach to minus below 0. So this is preventing that and adjusting and fixing. And here is a point that sends the signal to the servo, the angle that you push. And this is just a text here will display on the serial monitor. And then here we set the value to a dot. Dot is something that I picked because it's not in this remote, not in this remote. So that was unusual point. So once you release the remote, this just sets it to that dot, so it will not take action. And then we wait 100 milliseconds and it continues. If you press a button, it will do it. And for the left, we do the same thing. And if we are center or reset, when you press, let's say, OK, then we set angle equal center angle, and then we pass it. That's why the servo goes to the middle. Now let me demonstrate controlling the servo. I've opened the sketch. The first thing that we do is I'm using the black remote. So for that, I have to put here B for black. And because this is a PCB and not this module, I set this equal 1. After that, here, because I'm going to control going right with this one, so that is the arrow that is printed. Unfortunately, they printed black on dark blue, so you cannot see it properly. But on the left, for the left, and for the center, press OK. So this will reset and bring the servo back to normal. The serial monitor. Now, if I send the signal properly, it will respond. I'm pressing it to the right. You can see it shows now it was 90, now it became 80, 70. And if you pay attention here, I have set the steps angle, step 10 degrees. For that reason, we are going 10. So you see 40 degrees. If I press OK or center, it goes back to the center, which is 90 degrees. Now if I press left, same way, it goes to the left. I've set this now to white. I'm using the white remote, and PCB is equal 1 because it's PCB. And I'm using this one with a CH plus to the right, CH minus to the left, and CH back to the center or reset. Now the serial monitor is open. You see, sometimes you get unknown because the switches are not properly contacting or sending the wrong code. And reset works. I'm pressing it back. So 180, that's the maximum. And after 180, you see when I press it, the command goes, but the program prevents it. And then press center, it goes to the center. I've set PCB equal 0 because I removed the PCB and I put this tiny module with the wires, and it's white W. Same way it works, and CH will bring it back to normal. Now I'm going to capture the code for this remote and control the servo instead of these remotes. Let's use the black remote when it says black remote. Because this is black, I'm just using the word black remote. And then let's check this and set it to B. This is black remote and this is not a PCB. So B black and PCB is equal 0. Now I've set this display code equal true, so when I press the keys here, it will display also the code. I'm planning to use this arrows, right, left, and enter. Pressing the right arrow will move this to the right, and pressing the left will move it to the left, and pressing enter will reset this. So that's my plan. First I have to capture it and see. I'm pressing the right. If I press the right here, it says unknown, which means none of the key matched, so that is good. Now with the current remote that I'm using with the black, now I'm pressing left. Left also doesn't match. You see unknown, but we are getting the code. And also let's try enter. So all of them matched, but it's possible that some of the key that you press and it says CH is pressed or something. This is a black remote. I'm gonna use this right and then left, replace this code, and for the OK, I'm gonna put enter. This is just common for myself, so I'm gonna capture the left one, which is this one first. Let me open a new monitor. So left, this is the code, double click, Control C. Come here, this is for the left, I'm putting it here. You see, 659, And then let's go for the right. 6b9, so multiple times is good. If you get consistent value, that's good. Double click, highlight, and then Control C, copy. And I'm gonna replace it in here. And for the enter, 6e9, consistent, that's good. Control C, come here and put it. Now, this key and this key is within the text, but enter is not there. So I'm gonna go for the black remote key and put this label instead of enter, okay. Which I have to, this is black with PCB. You see here, black remote key. This is top, left, right, and then this is okay. I'm gonna change it to enter. That is done. Now, we set our values here. For the right, for the left, and then for the center, enter. So when this matches the list that we had there, then it will work. Now let's upload it. Just let's try it. So as you can see, it goes 10 degrees to the right. And it reached 0 degrees. Now if I want to go to the left, it will work the same way. And if I want to reset it or press it, let's go fully to the left and enter, will bring it back to center. As you can see, it's rotating. And enter, we'll bring it to center. Thank you for watching. This was the video explaining how to use remote control with Arduino or maybe your home remote control to control a servo motor. Please thumb up the video if you like it, and also follow us on Facebook and subscribe. I appreciate it.